this will deal with both band pass sampling and band rejection sampling. Okay, so before that we'll study some basic concepts. What is sampling? Okay, for the definition of sampling, I can say that sampling converts continuous analog signal to discontinuous analog. It is not a digital, it become a discontinuous analog signal. Okay, digital becomes after quantization. Okay, now a sampler is there. To this sampler, there are two inputs. One input is message signal, that is a baseband signal. Second one is a delta T, that is called a sampling signal. Okay. The output of this is a sampled message signal. Okay, where sampled message signal is mt dot delta t. Okay, I can name this block as a sampler block. Now, by shifting theorem, I know ft dot delta t is equal to ft at t equal to 0. Ft dot delta of t minus 1 equal to ft at t equal to 1. Okay. Now, how this sampling function, sampling signal will arrive? Okay. So, what is the mathematics behind this sampling signal? See, this property is called shifting property. This is useful in sampling. I can write my impulse delta t as limit a tending to 0 1 upon a u of t minus u of t minus a. Okay, minus infinity to infinity delta t dt is equal to 1. Each impulse is practically each impulse is approximated by a pulse of unit height and infinitesimal bit. That means pulse of unit height and infinitesimal width. Okay, so each impulse is denoted by a pulse of unit height and infinitesimal width. Actually, this is a theoretical definition, but generally in practical this will not happen. So, but we have to make the case which are more comparable with the theoretical concept also. Okay, so I can write my sampling signal is equal to summation k tending to minus infinity to infinity delta of t minus k ts. Okay, this is my sampling signal. Now if we go to the frequency analysis of this sampling signal, we just get some very interesting results. Just write frequency analysis. Now we are seeing this. This is a periodic signal. So definitely it will possess a Fourier coefficient. So Fourier coefficient it will possess. So once they are Fourier coefficient, so we have to find the वेरियस फूरियर कोफिशिएंट्स ए नॉट ए एन बी एन। ए नॉट इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय टी एफ माइनस टी एफ बाय टू टू टी एफ बाय टू डेल्टा टी डी टी इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय टी एफ। ओके ए एन 2 बाय टी एस माइनस टी एस बाय टू टू टी एस बाय टू डेल्टा टी कॉस एन ओमेगा एस टी डी टी दिस इज इक्वल टू 2 बाय टी एस। इफ यू सॉल्व दिस इंटीग्रल विल गेट द रिजल्ट एज 2 बाय टी एस। बी एन बी एन इक्वल टू 0 बिकॉज even signal directly we can discard that. So my summation k tending to minus infinity to infinity delta of t minus k ts it can be written as 1 by ts plus summation n tending to 1 to infinity 2 by ts cos n omega s. Okay, this is a Fourier analysis of sampling signal. Now I can write my sample message MST as nothing but MT by TS plus 2 by TS summation n tending to 1 to infinity MT cos n omega S. Okay, so this is a Fourier analysis of the sampling signal. Now, next topic is band limited oblique low pass signal sampling theorem. This theorem says that a band limited signal band limited to FM hertz. Can be specified in terms of sample taken for every sampling interval TS such that TS should be lesser than equal to 1 by 2 FS or FS be greater than 2 FN samples per cycle. Okay, this particular theorem is called Nyquist theorem. This is a case with band limited signals. We will further see that in case of band pass signals, this theorem may not be useful. This theorem is always useful, but in case of band pass signal, we can sample a signal even lower frequency than the Nyquist frequency also. Okay. See the case. Any band limited signal from 0 to FN, when I sample with frequency equal to 2 FM, then I can get a sample at each point likewise 4 FM go further. Okay. Now, for reconstructing this, I just need a low pass filter of this cutoff. Okay. So when I have low pass filter of this, I'll get my signal back, and the remaining terms, remaining things can be removed out. Okay. But for constructing an ideal low pass filter, it is almost impossible. Why so? Because ideal low pass filter are not a causal system. We'll see why they are not a causal system. Okay. But we know the condition of causality, that the condition of causality says that if there is a dose, this impulse response of a system should be zero for t value lesser than zero. Okay. For a low pass filter, I have filter response somewhat like this, having a sharp cutoff at particular frequency. I can name this frequency as minus fc to plus fc. Okay. If I see the time domain impulse response of this, I have to find the inverse Fourier transform. One dot, let this amplitude of this be one. One dot e to the power j 2 pi ft df. Okay. On solving this integral, I will get terms like e to the power j 2 pi f t by j 2 pi f minus f c to plus f c. I will get sine omega c t upon phi t. Okay, this terms, if I plot the impulse response of this, it will be like sink. Now, by looking at this, I can clearly tell that this sink is present for t value minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, that means ht is not equal to 0 for t lesser than 0. That means it is a non-causal system. That means now if a system is a non-causal system, that it cannot be realized, because if a system is non-causal, it becomes an anticipative system. Okay, anticipative system means a system can predict the future values without giving an input. Such systems are practically not possible. So to remove this, things which we can do is to shift this impulse response by infinite delay. But if we shift system by infinite delay, then also again a problem. Because if we shift a system response by infinite delay, then we'll never get the output in that case. But then the other solution of this is not to have a sharp cutoff in the frequency band. Okay. If we can reduce that sharp cutoff, we can have a system which is a causal system or non-anticipative nature system. Let's write a note. An ideal low pass filter can be made as causal by providing infinite amount of system delay. Okay. So they can be made causal system. Now, reconstruction can be simpler if sampling frequency fs is greater than 2fs. But this particular case has got certain other features, certain other effects on the certain following characteristics of the system. First, by this fs greater than 2 fm, first thing is reconstruction इज मोर प्रैक्टिकल. मोर प्रैक्टिकल मीन्स इट कैन बी इजिली डिजाइंड. सेकेंड थिंग इज अनवांटेड फ्रीक्वेंसी कॉम्पोनेंट कैन बी रिड्यूस्ड. थर्ड वन इज दैट इज थर्ड इज अ डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ दिस. इफ आई हैविंग अ सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी ग्रेटर देन ट्वाइस द मैसेज सिग्नल फ्रीक्वेंसी, मैक्सिमम सिग्नल फ्रीक्वेंसी प्रेजेंट इन अ मैसेज, देन इट रिजल्ट्स इन इनएफिशिएंट यूज ऑफ बैंडविड्थ. ऑफ चैनल बैंडविड्थ इट रिजल्ट्स इन वेस्टेज ऑफ चैनल बैंडविड्थ. ओके, सो डेफिनेटली वी हैव टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज ओवर द चूजिंग द सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. नाउ इफ आई हैव एफ एस लेसर देन 2 FM देन आई हैव समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड एलियासिंग. दिस रिजल्ट इन एलियासिंग. Somewhere I have FS. This particular frequency is called FS by 2, called folding over frequency. This particular region is called due to aliasing. Okay. In such case, recovery of only baseband signal is not possible, okay, because some other frequency component also get inserted into the low pass filter. Because now if I have a low pass filter which is like this, then definitely I am going to have this frequency component also, okay, which are not desirable. Okay, to avoid this, what we can do is use anti-aliasing filter. Anti-aliasing filter allows only those components to be passed which are required to be there, such that the sampling frequency, such that the maximum frequency after the anti-aliasing filter is 1/2 the sampling frequency of the system. Okay, so this is a case with band limited signal or baseband signal. Now we will see the case for band pass signal. Under the band pass sample, it is not always required to use the Nyquist frequency. We can also sample a message signal even at the low frequency. Okay. Now, sampling theorem. For band pass signals. Now, what is band pass signal? Band pass signals are those signals in which the lower cutoff frequency is not equal to 0, upper cutoff frequency is also not equal to 0. Definitely that cannot be equal to 0. Okay. So in such case, how to find the sampling frequency? Now, write down first band pass signals are those in which lower cutoff frequency and higher cutoff frequency are not zero. Any of the frequencies are not zero. Now there exists a two case to find the sampling frequency. First case is इफ आइदर ऑफ एफ एच और एफ एल इज एन इंटीजर मल्टीपल ऑफ टू टाइम्स ऑफ एफ एच माइनस एफ एल, फिर एफ एच माइनस एफ एल इज बैंडविड्थ, सॉरी ओनली टू मल्टीपल ऑफ एफ एच माइनस एफ एल, देन टू टाइम्स ऑफ एफ एच माइनस एफ एल इज द मिनिमम सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई हैव वन सिग्नल विच इज प्रेजेंट बिटवीन 5 किलोहर्ट्ज टू 10 किलोहर्ट्ज, देन इन सच केस द सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी विल बी, सी फर्स्ट 10 माइनस 5 किलोहर्ट्ज इज इक्वल टू 5 किलोहर्ट्ज. दिस 5 किलोहर्ट्ज इज इंटीजर मल्टीपल ऑफ लोअर फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड अपर फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑल्सो, बिकॉज 5 × 1 इज इक्वल टू 5, 5 × 2 इज इक्वल टू 10. ओके, दस इन दिस केस सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी इज इक्वल टू 2 टाइम्स ऑफ 5 किलोहर्ट्ज इक्वल टू 10 किलोहर्ट्ज. Okay, so this was the first case. Now there may be also a possibility that instead of 10, it may be 12 kilohertz. So in that case, there is a different procedure to find out. Okay. Case 2. Now in this case, FH minus FL is not an integer multiple of lower cutoff frequency or upper cutoff frequency. So in this case, the procedure is, if FH minus FL is not an integer multiple. Okay. Now, in this, the step to find the sampling frequency. Sampling frequency in this FS min is equal to 2 times of FH by N. FH is upper cutoff frequency and N can be found by using FH by B, where B is the bandwidth. N should be largest integer not exceeding okay. For example, how to find the bandwidth for this one? Suppose this is 7 kilohertz and this is 12 kilohertz. So what is the sampling minimum sampling frequency required here? See, bandwidth in this case is 5 kilohertz. Okay. So now bandwidth is 5 kilohertz and this 5 kilohertz, FH minus FL, is neither an integer multiple for 7 and for 12. Now what to do? Now in this case you have to find the N. N is nothing but 12 by 5. 12 by 5 it becomes 2.4. We have to take largest integer not exceeding N. Therefore it will become 2. Okay. So FS minimum is equal to 2 into FH by N. This will become 12 kilohertz. Okay, so in this case, this is sampling frequency is formed. So we have seen the sampling for band baseband signal and sampling for bandpass signal also. Okay, now we will see few problems related to sampling, which completes our topic. Problem. Find Nyquist सैम्पलिंग रेट फॉर सिग्नल साइन एटी बाई पाई टी. I have to find the sampling rate for this. Now, we have to apply before knowing what is the maximum frequency present in this. For that, we have to apply the duality principle. So we know that by duality principle, if FT has got f of omega as a Fourier transform, then FT can be written as 2 pi f of minus omega. Okay, so 2 sine at by t will have Fourier transform 2 pi minus a to a amplitude 1. Okay, that means sine at by pi t will have Fourier transform something like minus a to a omega m equal to a fm equal to a by 2 pi. Okay, thus Nyquist sampling frequency will become 2 fm, or it can be written as 2 into a by 2 pi, which is equal to a by pi. Okay, so this is a way of finding the sampling frequency in such cases. Otherwise, if we can able to find the frequency directly from the time domain signal, then we can avoid such process. Another problem. Suppose xt has got Fourier transform as x of j omega, where x of j omega is something like this. This is minus 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 minus 2 pi into plus 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 magnitude 1. This is my x of j omega. Then find sampling frequency for x square t. Okay, you have to find sampling frequency for x square t. We know that for xt, x of j omega is a Fourier transform and x of j omega plot is given. So now, xt square t can be written as xt multiplied by xt. Okay, this is multiplied. Now, from the properties, we know that multiplication in time domain becomes convolution in frequency domain. The maximum frequency which is present in xt is 10 kilohertz, but in x square t it will be thus x of j omega will contain frequencies up to 2 into 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 or 20 kilohertz. Thus maximum frequency present in x sine x square t is 20 kilohertz. According to that, Nyquist frequency will be 2 times of 20 kilohertz. Become 40 kilohertz. So this way this problem is solved. Okay. So be careful while thinking with what to do. Okay. See, multiplication in time domain goes to convolution in frequency domain. Convolution in time domain goes to multiplication in frequency domain. Suppose if there are two signals xt, it is conjugated with, it is convolved with xt, then there will be multiplication in time in frequency domain. So we have to multiply that plot. We have, we just by looking at the plot, we should see till what range the frequency will lie. Again, just looking at the range of the frequencies and finding the maximum frequency there, we can easily find the Nyquist sampling frequency from that. Okay, so these are the two basic problems, and remaining problems are very easy. Just finding the maximum frequency, we can find the Nyquist sampling frequency by multiplying it by 2. Okay, so these are the few basic typical problems which are generally asked from this topic of sampling theorem.